If you're on a Unix-like system, whether that be Linux, macOS, some BSD variant or something else, you are going to have a Unix toolset. Now on Linux, that is typically the GNU Core Utils. The Core Utils are so common that a lot of people don't realize that Core Utils is specifically a GNU term and not a reference to any Unix toolset. This is not the only one you'll see though. Especially in embedded contexts, you're a lot more likely to see BusyBox as this has a much smaller installed size. But on Linux, that is not the only one you'll see. Another one gaining quite a bit of steam is UUtils. If you know, you know. If you don't, cross-platform Raspberry Write of the GNU Core Utils. UUtils aims to be a drop-in replacement for the GNU Core Utils. Differences with GNU are treated as bugs. Now, differences with GNU is a very key phrase here. While some sort of implementation of a Unix toolset exists across basically every platform, even Windows has multiple implementations, whether you want to look at something like Cygwin or, you know, literally using Linux and running WSL. These mostly conform to each other. There is a standard known as POSIX. This is basically the minimal subset for what is a Unix toolset. However, some of them, especially GNU, do things in addition to POSIX. So if you're a developer writing scripts and you don't know what is and isn't POSIX, you might use GNU-specific features and make a script that is platform dependent. And whilst I'm talking about Linux here, UUtils is not a Linux specific thing. These are the same utils on Linux, macOS, Windows, and other platforms. So this is a consistent implementation where if you need to work with GNU, you can work with GNU. And at the same time, written in Rust and not C. We will get into that a little bit later, but first, let's get to the main point of why I'm talking about this. From the Ubuntu forums posted by John Seeger, carefully but purposely oxidizing Ubuntu. This is a follow-up to a prior post posted back in February. Engineering Ubuntu for the next 20 years. This goes over a lot of things that have improved over the past 20 years of the project and things that should be done or are being looked into to make sure the project is, you know, still around in 20 years from now. But the one part I want to focus on is this right here. We should look deeply at the tools we ship with Ubuntu by default, selecting tools that have resilience, performance, and maintainability at their core. There are countless examples in the open source community of tools being re-engineered and reimagined using tools and practices that have only relatively recently become available. Some of my personal favorites include command line utilities such as Ezza, Bat, Helix, and the new Ghosty Terminal emulator, and more foundational projects such as UUtils, a rewrite of Core Utils in Rust. Each of these projects are at varying levels of maturity, but have demonstrated a vision for a more modern Unix-like experience that emphasizes resilience, performance, and usability. Now, none of this is to say that these are going to become defaults on Ubuntu. Could happen. There are packages for all of these, I believe. So you could use them. I don't think I clicked that link. But the main point here is, how do you build upon the Ubuntu platform? Back to the main post. Over the years, projects like GNU Core Utils have been instrumental in shaping the Unix-like experience that Ubuntu and other Linux distributions ship to millions of users. Honestly, I think it's a lot more than that. If GNU didn't come along and basically start a collaboration between Linux and GNU, I don't think Linux would have been much more than a hobby project, or if it was, it would have taken considerably longer. Having that toolset there from the very, very start honestly made it so you could actually use the system and it wasn't literally just the kernel. Now, there were plenty of other toolsets at the time and something else could have filled that role, but GNU stepped in very early, starting with Ubuntu 25.10. My goal is to adopt some of these modern implementations as the default. My immediate goal is to make UUtils Core Utils implementation the default in Ubuntu 25.10, and subsequently in our next long-term support LTS release, Ubuntu 26.04 LTS, if the conditions are right. And this is a very key part. And we'll certainly get to that, but the big question, why? If the GNU Core Utils have been fine all these years, why? There have for sure been vulnerabilities with these tools, don't get me wrong, but it's not like these tools are a constant source of stress where every other week some new vulnerability is discovered. These tools aren't in rapid development anymore, it's pretty much just in maintenance mode. You know what I love? Making a straw man and then arguing against the straw man. Performance is a frequently cited rationale for rewrite it in Rust projects. Maybe third or fourth down the list, but it's certainly not number one. While performance is high on my list of priorities, it's not the primary driver behind these changes. These utilities are at the heart of the distribution, and it's the enhanced resilience and safety that is more easily achieved with Rust ports that are most attractive to me. The Rust language, its type system and its borrow checker, and its community work together to encourage developers to write safe, sound, resilient software. With added safety comes an increase in security guarantees, and with an increase in security comes an increase in overall resilience of the system. And where better to start than the foundational tools that build the distribution? This right here is the actual reason people suggest doing Rust rewrites. And also, like, this bit right here. This first part is just like, well, no, I'm sure if you're going from like a Python project to a Rust project, then performance is a thing that is mentioned. But if you're going from C to Rust, unless that C code is horribly written, that's probably not a major consideration. I recently read an article about targeting foundational software with Rust in 2025. Among other things, the article asserts that foundational software needs performance, reliability, and productivity. If foundational software fails, so do all the other layers built on top. If foundational packages have performance bottlenecks, they become a flaw on the performance achievable by the layers above. I will leave this linked in the description down below. If you'd like to go and read it, check it out down there. But this is a really, really good point, right? Modern software is layers upon layers upon layers upon layers upon layers. You've all seen the XKCD of all of these fancy layers on top, and everything is held up by this like one little pillar of some random package maintained by one guy who doesn't make any money. That's modern software. And some people want to frame that as a bad thing. I don't think that's necessarily the case. It allows for far more complex software to be built with way less effort. But at the same time, it does make the stack very complicated and arguably more difficult to maintain. And there's also the matter of increasing the number of contributors to Ubuntu. I think projects like this will help. Rust may present a steeper learning curve than C in some ways. A lot of people would recommend not starting with Rust because a lot of the protections that Rust provides you only make sense in the context of you understanding why those protections are important, right? Like, yes, the borrow checker is good, but if you don't know why the borrow checker is doing what it's doing, it's gonna seem like it's not providing any value and actually actively harming your ability to learn. But providing such a strong framework around the use of memory, it also lowers the chances that a contributor accidentally commits potentially unsafe code. I do think what also helps is right now Rust is like the hip, cool, new language. Not really new, but it's the language that everybody is talking about, that everybody is excited to learn. Now, I know people don't think about it like this now, but feel free to clip this. Rust today is Java of the 90s. It is the language that everybody wants to learn. It is the language that is being integrated into everything. And we'll see how that goes long term. Now, whilst the plan is to bring UU Tools to an Ubuntu system near you soon, if you want to try it out now and probably not balk your system, now, it's experimental and you probably shouldn't do this just yet if you really care about your system, there is a tool where you can swap things out. This is called Oxidizer, a command line utility for managing system experiments that replace traditional Unix utilities with modern Rust-based alternatives on Ubuntu systems. Whilst it does say relatively low risk, I would say don't do this on a production machine, or at least a production machine you're not willing to possibly balk. You have been warned. Now, one thing I didn't mention earlier is this isn't just about UU Tools. Something else is being included. Sudo RS. Now, the name should make it obvious. This is a Rust re-implementation of sudo and su. Now, if you want to talk about tools that have had countless vulnerabilities, here is a tool that you can definitely look to. Here is a tool which could very much benefit from memory safe code. In the state they're currently in, the tools are not perfect, so if you'd like to help out, if you just generally want to see more Rust in the ecosystem, this is the time to do so, because by the time they go into Ubuntu, and especially when they make it to LTS, well, let's just hope they're fully ready by then. Earlier this week, I met with Sylvester to discuss my proposal to make UU Tools Core Utils the default in Ubuntu 25.10. We really need to come up with a better way to say this. UU Tools Core Utils is awful. Just call it UU Tools. Just call it UU Tools. Just drop this. Don't need this anymore. Yeah, actually, you know what? Perfect. Yeah, just UU Tools. If you want to say it, maybe... No, just this is fine. UU Tools it is. Anyway. Make it the default in 25.10. I was pleased to hear that he feels the project is ready for that level of exposure. So now we just need to work out specifics. The Ubuntu Foundation's team is already working on a plan for the next cycle. There are problems. For example, there are some missing dash capital Z flags, which are used for SE Linux. So... that's probably important. And I believe locale also isn't fully developed either. So if you're not an English speaker, well, that's a problem as well. And there's other just random little things where it's not fully done. Keep in mind, the goal is to make it one-to-one GNU. So at some point, those things are going to be addressed. However... some of these things have been sitting open for quite a while. For example, 2021, CP, LS, MV, implement SE Linux context handling. It's almost 4 years, and that's pretty important. And the plan is to work with the upstream maintainers to get issues like this resolved, so hopefully things like this actually get ironed out. Now, sudo RS is in the experiment, but the goal isn't to make that the default in 25.10. If it is suitable, maybe sometime down the line, that is gonna happen as well. Now, I know this isn't a big deal for everyone, but this isn't a GPL v3 any sort of project. This is MIT. I personally don't have any issue with that being done. I'm fine with using MIT tooling. But I have seen a couple of complaints about moving from something GPL v3 plus over to MIT as, I don't know, you know, this could lead to... moving away from traditional Linux values. It invites corporations to come in and just yoink community labor. And I do get that concern. I just don't really think it makes any sense as a concern. When this isn't a new project that Ubuntu is starting, they're adopting an existing project. If somebody comes along and says, okay, I want to take UU Tools and I'm going to just like put it in my thing, like that doesn't actually... affect Ubuntu in any way. Also, just because they're changing the core utils from GPL v3 to MIT, Don't read too much into this. This is not symbolic of any pointed move away from GNU components. It's literally just about replacing core utils with a more modern equivalent. Sure, the license is different, and it's a consideration, but it's by no means a driver in the decision making. Now, if it was a license that wouldn't be compatible, sure, but MIT fits perfectly well into a Linux project. I'm generally in favor of playing around with these experiments, but I don't know if it's a good idea to swap to UUtils yet, right? Like, the goal, long run, to be one-to-one GNU. But as it stands, things are still missing not as much as when I first looked at the project, right? Like, when I first looked at it, they had nothing. And it's most of the way there now, and you actually can use it. But it's always going to be those edge cases that always trip people up. And I don't know if it's going to be fully ready by the time they do their 25.10 feature freeze. If it's not, I really hope they wait, because putting that into an LTS when it is not ready, that's going to be a rough LTS release. But what do you think? Do you think this is a waste of time? Do you think other distros should possibly experiment with this? I know Fedora's had some discussions here and there about doing so, but the value in doing it isn't really entirely clear. So we'll see how that actually goes. Look, maybe at some point, the whole GNU Linux thing is going to be entirely done. No more core utils. No more glibc. Do everything with Clang. And then we can truly live in the future. If you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Berape, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and I'm a bit rusty. Like this.